How to use symbols in Affinity Photo. First thing to do, have Designer. You need both applications. So if you've got Affinity Designer, you've got symbols. You can also use them in Photo. So simply just go over here. I'm going to create a shape. Just go to the Tools panel, create anything, an ellipse, image, whatever. Once you've done that, you can add, of course, other designs to it. I'm just going to quickly create another circle and maybe just change the color. So you can see there's a bit of a difference. Now, to create a symbol, what you need to do is you need to group those. So just go over there, and this is the Layers panel, and right click and group. So now they're all in one group, and you can resize it a bit. Just quickly resize, and then you go over here, and there's Create. So create it as a symbol. You can see now a symbol there. Now, if I drag this to this document, and this is in Designer, what you can do, you can then, of course, hold down the Alt or Option key and duplicate it. And again, it's another symbol. You can see over here, symbol, or you could just drag again from this panel, the symbols panel. So I'm just going to move that out of the way now. I've created a number of designs. Now, what I can do, I can go to File and Edit in Photo. What you can also do, if you want to do it, it's a bit longer, you can save as, or save the document. So save this document as an Affinity format file and then reopen it in Affinity Photo. That's the great strength of Affinity Photo, Affinity Publisher, Affinity Designer. You can use all the resources backwards and forwards in that one file format. And so you can turn around and say, now not everything works. There's some things where clearly they're not going to work, like macros and things, I'm certain. A bit tricky, I would imagine. But certainly a considerable amount of things like symbols can work across all the applications. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go up here instead. I'm just going to go to File and Edit in Photo. I could use Publisher as well, perfectly reasonable. So Edit in Photo. And then you can see now where I've got, these got exactly the same designs. This file is exactly identical. Again, as if I just went to File and Save As and saved it to an obviously Affinity format file. Not TIFF, not PSD, etc., just their format. And now you can see symbols, and you can actually open that up, and this is in Photo. So in Photo, what you've got, of course, you've got, let's just go to, so you could use filters, which of course you haven't got in Affinity Designer, but you can go to New Live Filter Layer here, and I'm just going to go for a very simple one, Blur. So Gaussian Blur, and I'm just going to blur the red. And now as I blur that, you can see what happens. They all blur. Also, I can go over here and I'm just going to select, say, that one, that design. And now I can go over here and go to Effects. And I can go, say, 3D. So I'm just going to add a 3D effect. See, okay, it's not the world's greatest design. I'm not saying it is. But you've got this design now. It's a symbol and they all change in each of these things. Like I say, there's no, if you go over here to View, Studio, and there's no symbols feature. You can't change it via the symbols panel, but you can go over here and change it here. So you can select any of these designs and then you change. So you change that, it will change there. Move it there, it will all change. Select that, that will change, and so on and so on. It's near enough like the very similar to layer and duplicate linked. Now I haven't tried that yet. It'd be interesting to see how that works, combining duplicate linked and symbols. Maybe that's for another day. But you can go through and see this design. So once you've done that, again, what you can do, you can save the file to Affinity format. Also, you can just say Edit in Designer. So you can go back and you see you've got exactly the same design as before. And again, still continue because they're still symbols. Still move it, resize because they're vectors. They can be any size. And you can see the format there, all exactly the same as there. And you can expand out. And you can see you've also got the Gaussian blur, which is very useful because of course you can then move the blur to other resources if you want in here. So you decide, you know what? I want that Gaussian blur too. And I can right click and I can duplicate. So I've got two there, but now I can say, you know what? Let's just move it up to there, to that one. And they all end up being blurred. So the weird imperfections here, I don't know what that is. Not very strange. Anyway, I'm certain that's just a weird video effect. So you got that design, change it, manipulate it, and again, go straight back, File and Edit in Photo if you want to continue to work. And you can always remove things as well. So if you decide, you know what, I don't want blurs, I can remove that blur. I can go to that blur and again remove that, and you can get back to the original design and move it around like that. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.